the TickTalk 2 comes with a free screen protector. When you first take off the protection film on the watch, wipe and clean the TickTalk screen before putting on the protector. Take off the back film first and put it in the middle of the screen. Remove the bubbles, then take off the front film. Now the TickTalk is good to go. To charge, open the charging base and put the TickTalk into the charging base. Make sure the charging port is properly attached to the charging connector of the charging base. Then, close and lock the charging base. Insert the charging cable into the micro USB port of the charging base and use the adapter to charge. Once it's charging, you will see a moving battery icon. The TickTalk will then go into sleep mode while it charges. It will take about 2 hours to fully charge. The TickTalk will only work with a micro SIM card. To insert the SIM card, open the back cover of the TickTalk. There will be a slot on the top right corner. Then follow the direction of the arrow to slide the metal frame to open. Put the SIM card into the TickTalk. Slide the metal frame back to lock the SIM. After the SIM card is locked in, put the back cover back on the TickTalk. Check to make sure the cover is completely on. Hold down the on and off button for 3 seconds and the TickTalk will turn on. You will first see your carrier's logo, then after a few seconds, there'll be a G icon that will pop up next to the signal bars. If the TickTalk shows an invalid SIM, it might be that your monthly plan is expired or that it has no credit. Refill the SIM or contact the carrier for help. If the TickTalk reads no service, please check if you have activated the SIM card. It could also mean that there is no 2G reception in your area. If so, please contact our customer service. If the TickTalk reads insert SIM, open the back cover to check if the SIM card is the right size. If the gold chip is facing down, make sure you slide the metal frame to lock the SIM card. Then restart the watch. Downloading the app. Search TickTalk 2 from either the App Store or Google Play to download the app. You can also scan the QR code on the user manual to download the app. Double check the spelling to make sure you have downloaded the TickTalk 2 app instead of the regular TickTalk app. Signing up. After you downloaded the app, please enter your personal information and email to sign up for a new account. Please create a 6 to 20 character password for your account, then input the password again. Click the Send a Verification Code icon. You will receive the verification by email. Input the code within 300 seconds, then click Next. To add a TickTalk 2, open the back cover. Look for the label with the watch's IMEI number and QR code. You can either scan the QR code or input the IMEI number to manually pair a new TickTalk to the app. Sign into the app with your email address and password. You can set up your contacts, send voice and text messages, and also locate the TickTalk through the app. Make sure the G icon pops up on the TickTalk when you log into the app. Adding another TickTalk 2. Click the arrow icon. On the top, you will see the Add Another TickTalk 2 option. Follow the steps to add multiple TickTalk 2 watches. To switch to a different watch, simply click on the watch user's name. For the kids' safety and your family privacy, the system defaults to the first person who paired the watch as the administrator. Any other members who join the app will need an approval from the administrator. The super hearing function can be used only by the administrator. If the administrator unbounds the TickTalk 2, all the other users have to pair the watch again to use the app. The system defaults to the first person who pairs to the watch as a new administrator. Setting up child's info. Click the arrow icon located on the top of the screen. Then click the edit icon next to the IMEI number. Click the top right corner edit icon to set up or edit your child's info. You can add your child's photo, input the name, the TickTalk's phone number, and other personal information. The TickTalk's phone number can be created when you activate the SIM card, or you can get the phone number from your SIM card provider. If you don't input the TickTalk's phone number, the super hearing function cannot be used. Press the green confirm button to save your information. There is a dad, mom, and SOS icon on the watch's interface. to allow the watch to let you use the click function to call parents and SOS numbers, you will need to preset the numbers in the app. Click the top left icon from the main menu. There will be options to input the dad, mom, and SOS numbers. Once the numbers are entered, the numbers will be synced to the watch within 1 minute. If you did not preset the numbers in the app or the phone numbers have failed to sync to the watch, the dad, mom, and SOS slots will read empty. In case of a real emergency, your child can save time by using the SOS button for help. Other than the dad, mom, and SOS numbers, the TickTalk 2 allows you to add extra 10 contacts of phone numbers in the app. It will usually sync these numbers to the TickTalk within 1 minute. If the firewall function on the watch is turned on, the numbers you didn't input in the app as contacts will be blocked when calling the TickTalk. Calling the TickTalk. You can either use the regular way by calling the TickTalk through your cell phone, or you can call through the app. For your child's privacy, please use the super hearing function limit for safety reasons only. To activate hearing function, input your personal numbers in the box as the listener's number. After 1 minute, the watch will call you back, so you can hear everything that's happening on the watch's end. Note, the watch's end cannot hear you. Only the administrator can use this function. If the watch is off, or if there is no reception, the super hearing function cannot be used. Click the locator icon to check the current location of the TickTalk. It will take about 10 to 30 seconds to locate. TickTalk's locator works in three modes: Wi-Fi, GPS, and LBS. The Wi-Fi mode will be the priority mode because it consumes less power. The GPS is the most accurate mode, but it's very power consuming. When you first use the locator function, the locator seeks the nearest public Wi-Fi hotspot and locates it. In Wi-Fi mode, the accuracy is about 100 to 500 feet. The locator will seek a GPS signal if it is unable to find a public Wi-Fi hotspot. In GPS mode, the accuracy is about 10 to 100 feet. If it is unable to find and connect to a public Wi-Fi or GPS signal, then it seeks the nearest cellular tower signal and uses the cell tower location. The accuracy in this mode is about 100 feet to 20 miles, depending how far the cell tower is from your TickTalk. Please see the locator icon in the app to check what mode of locating is being used. Depending on the GPS server, the locating supplier, or your cellular carrier, your TickTalk may switch between different modes of locating, and as it switches between modes, the accuracy may also change. To improve the accuracy, go to Settings to change the locating mode to Tracking mode. Route History Playback. Click the orange footprint icon to view the history route. Select the start time and end time, then click Playback. It will show the route history your child has been to during the time frame. The TickTalk will locate every 10 minutes automatically. During school time, you can set the watch to Do Not Disturb mode. The app allows you to set up 5 different time frames. You can make a label, set up the time frame, and repeat the days. When it's in Do Not Disturb mode, all functions on the watch will be blocked, except for the SOS phone calls. The Things to Do Reminder is a new function we brought to the TickTalk 2. It helps parents create routines and tasks for your child. It's a smart way for your kids to follow schedules, learn good habits, and good time management. To set up, click the plus icon on the top right of the screen to add Things to Do Reminders for your child. You can set up the time and repeat days in the app. It will show an icon with a ringtone on the watch's end to remind your child when the time is up. Clicking the red cross stops the reminder, and clicking the pause icon on the left of the screen pauses the reminder. The reminder will ring again every 5 minutes until you choose to stop it. If your app shows sync failed, please sign out of the app, then sign back in to allow the app to try to sync again. Please follow us on Facebook for more updated news. For customer service or technical support, please send us an email or call us. Thanks for choosing TickTalk.